The Royal Gramma is perhaps one of the most recognizable fish in our hobby, and unfortunately, they're pretty misunderstood. After researching the care requirements, I have heard from many people the do's and don'ts of keeping a Royal Gramma. Conflicting information from forums and saltwater veterans is nothing new if you've been in the hobby for some time. Royal Grammas are no exception. Today we're going to learn the basic care requirements for Royal Grammas and dispel the myth, once and for all, that you probably have all heard about this beautiful fish. One thing that you might find surprising about this warm water species is that it is more of a deep water fish. You probably wouldn't find it swimming on the reef with tangs and wrasses. Being more of a solitary species, they have been recorded living below 65 meters, roughly 215 feet deep. It's quite a bit deeper than your average aquarium. Their habitats are on cliff walls of the reef, and they are not nomadic. If you ever have seen one in an aquarium, you probably wouldn't be surprised that they live in small caves between reef rocks, corals, or sponges. In the aquarium, it is important that you have enough live rock so that they can have a cave to hide in when they feel frightened. However, this doesn't mean that you are going to necessarily get a shy individual. I've been the owner of multiple Royal Grammas, and I have had very shy individuals, and I currently have very sociable individuals. Much like a dog or cat, the personality of a fish really depends on the individual you bring home. This is no exception with the Royal Grammas. It is common not to see your Gramma for a day or two when you first introduce him into your system. However, don't be surprised if he is out and about the same day ready to be fed. One interesting thing to note, I have seen them more willing to come out on the first day if there are already other fish in the system. Alright, so now it's time to dispel the myth I talked about earlier in the video. Can you keep Royal Grammas together in one aquarium? The answer is yes. When you have read it on the forums and you've heard it from your local fish store owners a million times, it has become a conditioned response to say no, you cannot keep Royal Grammas together. I'm going to blow your mind though. I have seen Royal Grammas successful in same species aquariums as little as 25 gallons. I currently have a pair in a 40 gallon breeder, and they completely accept one another. They even live in the same cave. This has led me to believe, hesitantly, that they are a mated pair. In conclusion, Royal Grammas do fine together, in pairs or in harems. But use some common sense when you get Royal Grammas. Their max territory in the wild is about 560 square inches. That's about 100 inches less than a 55-gallon aquarium. In the end, it's your decision to make, but if you want to keep three or more, I would not recommend going smaller than 55 gallons. If you are a saltwater aquarist and want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe to my channel. Happy reefing, guys.